and welcome to another episode of Game On. I am Slash Raptor, and this is Ratchet Deadlocked. In the last episode, we defeated Ace Hardlight and received the Liberator armor, which we are now wearing. I really like this one. It's like, I think it's my second favorite. I still like the Crusader a little bit more. So now Gleam and Vox has sentenced us to die on the Gauntlet of Doom, or the Ghost Station. And I just felt like scrolling through that because we're all done. We've done all of the Dread Zone challenges available. Every single one of them is done. Except those couple ones that I decided not to do. See, look at this. I've already got 2 skill points here. I've never even been to the Ghost Station. I got Friendly Fire, and I've got Meltdown. Okay. I've never been to the Ghost Station, but yet I've got 2 skill points for it. Speaking of the Ghost Station, let's go to the Ghost Station. And, in the Ghost Station, you will meet such riveting enemies such as Ghost Robot Zombies. But first, there's a cutscene.
My friends, it is a black day for Dread Zone fans across the galaxy. Ace Hardlight, champion exterminator and respected philanthropist, was brutally cut down by the maniac contestant known as Ratchet, aka the Butcher of Bogan.
Fans reacted to Ace's defeat with shock and outrage. Look, we hate you, Ratchet. You cheated.
Ratchet is a malicious criminal. He must be punished.
Bowing to public pressure, Gleam and Vox acted quickly to address the issue.
Fans of Dread Zone, I share your pain for the loss of the mighty Ace Hardlight. I encourage you all to express your grief and sympathy by purchasing this limited edition Ace Hardlight Memorial Action Figure on sale now for only 299 volts.
A Vox News investigation later revealed that Ratchet used banned performance-enhancing drugs.
In accordance with Dread Zone Regulation C6-5/9, Paragraph 2, Ratchet has been sentenced to meet his fate on the Gauntlet of Doom! This special event will be broadcast live tomorrow night only on Dread Zone!
Why would they broadcast it live? Because, like, what if I escape? Then it's not me being sentenced to die, then it's just another campaign.
I cannot believe this, folks! We are live from some blar gobble station out in the middle of nowhere. Ratchet and Clank, aka Team Darkstar, have conquered 9 planets, survived hundreds of arena battles, and even defeated Dread Zone's grand champion, Ace Hardlight! Who would have ever imagined this? Now, in a drastic and downright vindictive move, Gleam and Vox has sent Team Darkstar to the Ghost Station! The course is unbeatable, unbearable, unthinkable, and I'm having an aneurysm just talking about it!
It's not unbeatable, and it's not unbearable. It's
Do
just
not worry,
pretty
Ratchet.
Long.
I will make sure you get out alive. My nav grid shows an abandoned supply ship on the other side of the station. There is a grind rail nearby that will take you to the station's core. I will give you more information when you get there.
Someday I will get it. Okay, so all of the enemies here are ghosts, but that doesn't really have any impact on, what they're weak against. They're basically just normal enemies that are translucent. Transparent, translucent. I don't know if there's a difference between those two words. My favorite, though, is still the robot ghost zombies. The ghost robot zombies. Zombie robot ghosts. How can you have a ghost zombie? If you're coming back as an undead thing, you're either going to be a ghost or a zombie. But I don't think you can be both. And since robots are not alive, they can't die, so you can't get a ghost robot or a zombie robot. But, okay, so we're gonna be fighting some ghost zombie robots. Ghost zombie robots! Everything is a ghost, but again, your attacks can still hit them, so it's just for an aesthetic change more than anything. This is definitely the longest campaign in the whole game. Unless you count the last thing. But I don't know if it's necessarily going to take me as long to beat as some of the other ones. Because it's not that hard, really. I still think that one part in Char where you had to get across that ice lake was much harder. I I mean, for the most part, all of the Dread Zone missions and campaigns are drastically over-exaggerated, but... Oh, well, I died. You're a robot. You can't get itchy. So I actually looked it up, and apparently it's what, during the early stages of production, the combat bots were intended to have feet and legs. And I'm glad they decided against it, because that just would have been weird. They were pretty much as tall as Ratchet. It just didn't look right. They never really tell us where this place is. All they ever say is it's just called the Ghost Station. The campaign is called the Ghost Station. Well, it could also be called the Gauntlet of Doom, but I think that's more of a nickname than an actual name. Like, they never say what this is a station of. Like, is it supposed to be, like a space station? Is it, like, a weather station? Is it a... I don't know. I guess it would be a space station. I mean, it kind of looks like a space station. Like a giant space station. But I'm not sure if all these rails and things that I'm grinding around on are also part of it.
Here to Florana, why don't we skip it and head back to my condo for a cocktail and a dip in the jacuzzi?
No, I prefer to stay here where the real action is.
Ooh, burn. Besides, Juanita's a robot. If she went into a jacuzzi, she would rust. Actually, not just a jacuzzi, any hot tub. Because remember, kids, all jacuzzis are hot tubs, but not all hot tubs are jacuzzis. It's a fun word to say. Jacuzzi. Jacuzzi. Kind of sounds like a some sort of an African predator animal. This here is the lair of the red jacuzzi, known for its vicious attacks on unhelpless travelers. The jacuzzi are known for their incredible savagery. I'm gonna go poke it with a stick. Crikey! So basically, you just kind of grind around and then go from little to node, and then eventually you'll create a complete path, and then that'll get you to the next stage of the objective. And I am about to die, and there you go. Yeah, okay, so I guess the only hard part about this is that they don't give you very many health crates. They give you lots of ammo, but I haven't seen many health crates at all. I don't seem to be getting any experience that much either, although I don't really pay much attention to the nanotech experience bar, because it just kind of happens on its own. See, there was a health crate there, but it's on the grind rail, and the grind rails are one way, so that doesn't help me. I need ones that I can actually go and run over to if I'm losing hit points. I think this is really the only part that I have had to do multiple times. But there's kind of like a checkpoint system in this one, because the enemies don't really respawn, so when you start at the beginning, you're really just starting at the beginning, as opposed to having to redo the entire thing again. That makes it a bit better. Okay, I wonder if I can get these now. These things will play a role in a later mission, so let's see what happens if I destroy some now. I think there's like 30 or 32 of them in total, so we'll see if that has an effect on whether or not I can get out of here faster. I think that's like the last thing you have to do is destroy all of those or something. It's been a while since I've played this. I do know you use the hover ship in here, though. Okay, guys, go get the grind rail. I mean, the node. Go do it. I'll cover you. They're also gonna need... No, they're not gonna, because the node will do it. When I turn the node, then that's when the grind rail comes from. Okay, so I think that's the last one. Yeah, see? Still no health. I don't really need it right now, but just pointing it out. Still no health. Oh, sure, now that I get some. Whoa, that was close. That should have exploded. Leave me alone. Alright. The end is in sight.
You know, I was just bluffing earlier. I knew Ratchet would pull it off. So, about the cocktail jacuzzi thing. Oh, isn't that a shame? Team Darkstar's only escape has been cut off. Wonder how they'll get past this one.
They are on to us, Ratchet. Dreadzone has activated a force field blocking you from the supply ship. However, if you can capture the control nodes in that quadrant, I believe I can override the force field.
But I just captured a bunch of nodes. Alright, let's capture some more nodes. Yeah, again, I still think that out of everything, that's the only thing I don't like about this game, is that you're really not doing anything during all these missions. You're just capturing nodes, or hacking orbs, or going from point A to point B. That's pretty much it. It's like the entire, pretty much every single mission involves just turning bolt cranks, or hacking orbs, or something like that. Or destroying so many of these things. But that's okay, because I still really love this game. It's so much fun. And I love how they were able to incorporate something new without losing without losing anything from the normal Ratchet and Clank games. Like, this is not, this game is not the black sheep of the herd. It's a fantastic game. The only thing that really sets it apart is that they just called it Ratchet Deadlocked. I still think they could have called it Ratchet and Clank Deadlocked, although that doesn't really sound as good, and Clank doesn't really have that much of a role, but to be fair, he doesn't really do a heck of a lot in most of the other games either. It wasn't until, like, A Crack in Time where Clank is really starting to become, like, useful. And I mean, in Tools of Destruction, he's kind of useful because he's the only one that can see the Zony, but even then, you don't play as him very often. I think you play as him, like, 3 times in the entire game. Okay, so now, I think there's basically, I think there's 4 nodes on this side, and then you have to get across to the other side, and then there's, I think, 1 more? So, because what we're basically doing right now is we're moving in a, it's a circular platform, and then there's like 4 rooms, like north, south, east, and west. I think that's 2 done? Maybe it's 2 or 3. There's not really a counter that says how many I've done so far. Get this dropship before it drops any more else. I'm not having a very easy time talking today. Stupid blade balls, go away! I froze a ghost. I'm gonna freeze another ghost. Ooh, a jackpot crate. Don't mind if I do. Leave us alone, you're not wanted here. Destroyed a couple more of those little things. Fusion rifle this dropship so it doesn't blow us up with those missiles. And now let's go back to the magma cannon and see if we can get more experience for it. Okay, I think there's 1 more. I lost count as to how many there are on this side, so let's just go around this corner and see if I and see if there's one more bolt crank to turn. I don't think there is. I think we've got them all. Yeah. So now we have to go find... I think there's little hookshot targets that you can use. And then you can swing from this side to the other. There they are. Arr, she blows! Off in the distance! Whee! Woohoo! This can be a pretty good fight. Here we go! We have robot ghost zombies! Yeah! Uh-oh, no ammo. Dual Vipers. Oh, no you don't. Go away! Leave us alone! Don't even think about shooting at me from up there! You stay away from that turret! Stop dropping enemies! Go away! Got more ammo now. I'm gonna use magma cannon on you. Yeah, die, 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 die. No, I'm out of ammo. Ooh. Oh, they blew it up. All right. Well, that could have been more entertaining. You blew up my dropship. I wanted to be the one to do it with my magma cannon. Whoa! Get away from that turret! Get him off the turret! Get him off the turret! Stop that! Let's see if I can take this one down. Yeah! There we go! Magma Cannon level up! Only 200? Feels like it's so much stronger than that. It's weird, but I mean, the Magma Cannon is so good. Like, it feels like it's a much stronger weapon than it really is. But the B6 doesn't really feel that way. I think that's like it's like the only weapon in the game where it just feels like it's not effective at all. But I never get that feeling with the magma cannon. I guess because it's just so useful against all the swarms. Maybe there isn't really that many objectives in this campaign. Maybe they're just longer overall missions. Because I think the next thing is we have to get to the hover ship, and then the last one is we take the hover ship and then try and escape. So that would add up to about 4, which is still the typical amount. Oh, another jackpot crate. Okay, so that's that bolt crank done. So where are we going? Oh, I guess we have to go and get back across where we swung across the first time. There they are. Whee! Woo! Woohoo! I see something. Oh, there it is. It's just over this way. Yeah! Mini turrets! You guys want a piece of this? Think you can stop us from getting out of here? You've got another thing coming! You've got another thing coming! And I'm gonna shoot you with the B6 obliterator! I took a lot of damage right there. I might die. I might die. That would suck if I die right now, right at the end of this mission. Don't die. Don't die. We got this. We're okay. Alrighty then.
Boss, I wasn't worried. Were you?
Challenge complete. Yeah, see, look at that. That was an 8-minute mission. Ah, yeah, and there's another one that we got over 100.
Nothing's easy in Red Zone, baby. Team Darkstar thinks they have a clear escape, but come on, folks. We're not letting them go that easy. I mean, this whole battle course is intended to send them to the grave.
Oh dear, you are still stuck. It appears there is a six-phase Theta Glyph encrypted force field blocking your escape. I am unable to crack the encryption from here. However, if you destroy the encryption computers that control the force field, that might short it out.
See, now this is different. We don't have to hack any orbs or anything. We just have to destroy the computers. So then let's get going. Let's destroy those computers. Let's just, for all intents and purposes, let's just assume that these are Macintosh computers, because that makes me feel better. I don't like destroying Windows computers unless they are completely not working. But a Macintosh computer, I would happily destroy a perfectly functional one. Except for the fact that I don't have $1,000 to spend on a Mac. And the only reason that I don't like Macs is because they cost way too much and really aren't that much better than PCs at all.
Orbit, that door's open.
Bring it on, Apple fanboys. Bring it on. Actually, one of the chefs in my culinary school is an Apple fanboy, but he's kind of like the opposite of what you would expect an Apple fanboy to be. He's kind of just like an arrogant... computer user. Like, instead of saying, oh, well, I went and waited at the Mac store for like 6 hours while the new product dropped, he'll just say, well, I had to go to the... Well, my laptop wasn't working, so I had to go to the school lab and use their computers, and I really hate using Mac computers. And I really hate using PC. So it's like, oh, well, all right then. So you hate PCs, and you're gonna tell everyone about it. Oh my God, it's ridiculous. He's got the iWatch. He's got like 7 iPhones. He has like one of those. He's got like 2 iPads, and then every single day it looks like he brings in a different MacBook of various models and sizes. Like, what the hell? The iWatch? Seriously? And I'll bet you that costs another $500. And you know, it does the exact same things as an iPhone, except you can't make calls with it, and it's really small, so you also can't really watch movies on it. But I'm sure it actually has fantastic battery life. Oh no, wait, it probably doesn't, because it's made by Apple. I mean, normally a watch is supposed to last forever, right? But probably not that one. The Fitbit is a cool idea. The iWatch is not. So basically, we just have to go See, I'm telling you, I have a hard time talking today. We have to go and destroy the computers, and then that should get rid of that force field we just saw on the right. And then that should let us go and get in the hover ship and get out of here. I'm in the ghost station. Ghost station. Ghost station. Is that a gravity wall? Well, then let's see what's up here. Probably just a jackpot crate. Oh, no, that's actually where we have to go. Scorpion flail level 8. Aw, yeah. Out of my way! I've got computers to destroy. Let's put the shock mod back on the dual vipers. The acid mod is okay, but I really just love me my shock mod. So that's one of them. And that's another one. And that's another one. And that's another one. And there you go. Just like that. We're able to get out of here. Challenge complete! Ooh, just under 100. Didn't quite make it that time.
Star has actually survived through the ghost station's infamous Gauntlet of Doom! It looks like it's all over. Or is it?
Ratchet, we must make sure they can never use this station again. Destroy the station's outer turrets that guard the power cores. Then, destroy the central core and bring the station down. We will deal with Box when you return.
Parents with impressionable children.
Okay, so no. When I destroyed them earlier, it had no effect on this mission. There's still 33 of them. Now, what you're supposed to do is destroy all of the turrets all over the place, and then you can destroy the power nodules, yeah. But you actually don't have to destroy the turrets at all. You can, but that's not part of the mission. All you really have to do is destroy the nodules. Like, this mission is going to take much longer if you spend time trying to destroy each and every one of those turrets, which I am not going to do, because I might as well split this video up into two parts that way, and I don't want to have to do that. I almost did it with the Dark Cathedral of Kronos video, but decided against it. That was definitely the longest campaign in the game, and it had way more than four. Although most of those missions were overall shorter, it just had more of them, because you fought like Shellshock like 12 times there. Yeah, see, like, you can get rid of all these turrets, but there's nothing telling you that you have to destroy them to actually complete this mission. And this is the final mission in the game, so... Well, unless you count the real last mission. This is, like, the... Okay, this is the last mission in this campaign. It used to take me a while to find all these things, but they're actually not hard to find. They like to put them in big clusters, so when you find one, you probably will never just find one on its own. I'm just gonna heal here really quick. Okay. And let's go this way. Oh yeah? You think you can shoot at me? I'll show you! Boom! He's dead. Pretty lights. I like the way the beams that they're shooting at me. I like the way they fly through the air. It's very colorful. 21 out of 33. Okay. May as well heal a little bit while I'm here. Oh, there's some. There's some there. Oh yeah. Have some of this. Yeah. Boom! And boom goes the dynamite! Whoa, what was that? Oh yeah, these are the ghost cycloids. See, like, there's so many of them. But they don't follow you, so you could probably just ignore them all and just keep going. One there. Another one over there. This one up there. This one over here. Alright. Less than half of them gone. No, I mean more than half of them gone. There's not really half of 33. I guess it would be like 16 and a half. Yes, I understand. I know what I know what they want me to do. I'm in the process of doing it. Yeah, here's a bunch up here. Some more over this way. Okay, you can go away now. I still understand what I'm supposed to be doing. All right. And there you go. Nope, not quite 100 that time either. Alright, let's get out of here.
Ratchet, now, come meet me back at our containment area. I have a plan.
Clank has a plan.
Ratchet, I have found a way to shut down the containment fields and release all the heroes.
You're kidding. That's amazing.
He's had help.
Al? You're alive. They said your body was beyond repair.
No biggie. I got a new one. Check this out.
What? Okay. He got shot in the he got shot in the waist, or like the hip. Why would they replace his arm and his head if he got shot in the hip? It doesn't make any sense.
So what? Reprogram it? Hack it?
Blast it! Just blow it up, and the fields go down.
Okay, so how do I get to the control level?
I have reprogrammed the Battle Dome shuttle to take you there, but it is a one-way ride.
Dum dum dum. Well, anyway, folks, that's about it for this episode of Game On. Thank you for joining me, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future, where we will play the final mission of the game, which is destroying the Battle Dome once and for all. So don't miss it, because it's going to be hopefully an awesome episode. It's the last mission, it's the final climax of the game, so yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye.